weights in my world. My laughter, I'm sure most of you know this story, but for those who don't, towards the end of the night, I was not feeling very well. I was praying to the porcelain gods.
She remembered.
Dawn, being the sweetheart and loving person that she is, grabbed a bottle of water
and some Advil
and proceeded to gently rub my back while I made amends to the gods. Well, somehow during the proceedings, Dawn managed to knock the toilet seat onto the back of my head. As I'm sure all you can imagine, more than Advil and a bottle of water was needed at the end of the evening. But Dawn, I always enjoy telling that story because I believe the actions within it describe some of your most wonderful qualities. Your nurture, care, incredibly loving, and devoted friend. And without a doubt, a complete plus. I love you so much, honey. And I know unequivocally that Wilbert is a smart and lucky man. So that's the point. In reflection, I suppose it was karma, not Dawn, that knocked over that toilet seat that day. As a few years earlier, I had inadvertently shot Will in the upper thigh with a paintball. Most of you don't know that was the day we first met. Safe to say, we did not immediately hit it off. But after a few more weekends of paintball, trips cramming six drives, surge, and his banana hammock into a hotel room.
Word.
And many other Skype conversations planning our next big idea to take over in the paintball industry. We quickly became best friends. Before I knew it, we were spending countless hours at work hours. And even more time on the weekends, skiing. No longer how to take over the paintball industry, but on how to take over the world. That was 6 years ago. And don't get me wrong, we have had plenty of exciting moments during that time. An unforgettable trip with Pete to Six Flags, which we've almost banned for life. 13 pictures of Blue Moon, a giant kiss boot, and a dare and a late night swim. Learning about vodka and pickles from Surge. And of course, the countless number of times that we have had to spend time searching for Callie's wallet, we lost it.
Yes,
so we
board
a flight home from another state. But Will, to me, the actions within those memories define your biggest qualities. You have the ambition, drive, and intelligence to succeed at whatever you want and whatever you set your mind to. Your dedication, selflessness, and love for those around you are second to none. And yet, as I try to summarize our friendship and who you are and what you mean to me and so many others in this room, I could not help but feel that the speech was incomplete. You are more than a friend, your family, and it was during one of the many rewrites of the speech I realized it doesn't take 1,000 or 100 words to describe what you mean to me. Will, it only takes one. You are my brother. And so I ask all of you to raise a glass and join me in a toast to my brother and his incredible wife, Dawn Will. I wish you countless years of happiness and joy together. I want you to know how much admiration and respect I have for both of you as you manage to start your new careers, and how much you will love you. Enjoy Aruba and make sure within the next 5 years you'll be a godsend. Perfectly warm, blessed ass to Santa.
Mr. Bumper, send us a big round of applause.